programmer. I am Rajashri and today we have to see the second part of manual testing interview questions and answers. So the previous part will be uploaded, so you have to check because the link is provided in the description box. Do check it out and let's begin with the second part of this video. So we can cover in first part the five basic questions based on manual testing now for freshers as well as experienced person. So in today's video we can see the next five questions. So the first question will be, at what stage of the SDLC does testing being in your opinion? That means in which stage of SDLC the testing being started. So what is your opinion, and when should testing start in your project and why? That kind of question, if you have to ask, then you have to answer. In SDLC testing, being from the requirement gathering stage, that means SDLC. What is the SDLC? SDLC means software development life cycle. And in this SDLC, testing being from your requirement gathering stage, which will be the first or first stage of your project. So at that requirement gathering stage, your SDLC testing being started. Then, but here in this stage, we are testing the ideas, not a code. Actual in the requirement gathering, at that stage, you only test the ideas of your customer, not a code you have to test in that stage. There are some phases in this testing criteria. So first of all, which is this right requirement? That means whenever your customer tells the requirement of him or her, then you have to test that actual is that right requirement, or are they complete the requirement, are they achievable, are they testable? That means all are the requirement are right and complete, as well as how it will be achieved, or actual it will be achievable or not, and it will be testable or not. We have to verify that. So this is the answer of that question. Then the next question, which will be, what is quality? Because whenever they ask about SDLC, then there are some chances to ask about quality. Then what is the quality? You have to define the quality. So quality is a degree of excellence with reference to customer satisfaction. That means quality is a degree of excellence. What is the degree of excellence? So your customer will be satisfied by your project or not, you have to verify that. And if your customer will be satisfied, then the quality of quality or degree of excellence is high. And whenever your customer will be unsatisfied, or there are some much more expectations of your customer from your side, then the degree of excellence will be low or medium. So I hope you understood what is the quality. Quality means degree of excellence with reference to customer satisfaction. In this case, you have to check your customer will be satisfied or not. None other that you have to, nothing to check here. You have to only check your customer will be satisfied or not. So this is the quality. Then the next question, difference between QA and QC. So what is the QA, QC? Whenever we talk about SDLC, then the most askable question, QA and QC difference. So we can see what is the QA. So QA is the quality assurance. So in this quality assurance, we give the assurance towards quality. So in this case, we provide the assurance towards quality. That means we provide high quality software, or the software which will be customer when we provide the software, your customer will be satisfied. All other things are assurance in this case of quality assurance. Then this QA or this quality assurance is process oriented, as well as it is used to prevent the defects which will be occur in the system. Then it belongs to verification, not a validation. It belongs to only verification. So then the next, what is the QC? We already see what is QA. QA is quality assurance. It will be provide the assurance towards your product quality. Then it is the process oriented, as well as it prevents defects which will be arrive in your system. Then it belongs to verification, not validation. All other things about QA. But what is QC? QC means quality control. In QA, we check the in QA we check the quality assurance, but in QC we check the quality control. So which does not ensure quality. Quality control actually does not ensure quality. It is product specific, not a process oriented, as well as it used for the detection of defect, not a prevention of defect. And as well as QC belongs to validation process, not a verification process. All are the things about QA and QC. And if you want to detailed video on quality assurance as well as quality control, please let me know in the comment section. I'll make sure to do the video on this topic also. So in QA and QC, after that, in the QA and QC, we already see the words verification, validation. Then let's see the question on that verification as well as validation. So the next question will be difference between validation and verification process. So what is the validation and what is the verification? Give the difference between both the things. If you have to ask this question, then you have to give the answer. First of all, we see the verification and then we can see validation. So what is a verification? Verification is the process of confirming whether the software meets its requirement or not. Verification means we have to verify or we have to confirm our software fulfill the requirement of client or not. So this process is known as verification. In this process, you can review the work product. That means in verification, you have to review the final product or the product which will be developed. That will be work as per client's requirement or not. We have to review that. And then in this verification, we build the product. We check we are build the product right, correctly or not, or any defect in that product. So all other things in verification. This verification is QA activity. That means quality assurance activity. Verification based on quality assurance. It performed by quality assurance team or by the developer. Quality assurance team as well as developer both are perform the verification process. And verification is cost as well as time effective. So low cost is required for verification, as well as in less time your verification will be done. And all other things about your verification. Let's see the what are the validation. Validation is the process of confirming the software meets user's requirement or not. In validation also, we have to confirm our software users fulfill user's requirement or not. And this process execute product as well as test its behavior. Your validation process is actual execute the product, final product, which will be produced or which will be developed by developer. And then after executing that product, in this validation phase, we also test the behavior of the product. We are built the right product or not. We have to also check that actual our product will be correctly developed or not, or any suggestions or any requirements are incomplete in that. So we have to check all other things in quality assurance, verification as well as validation, both the process. But your validation is QC activity. We can see verification is based on quality assurance, so validation is based on quality control activity. So this validation performed by QC team, that means quality assurance team, quality control team, or by the user or by the tester. Verification done by quality assurance team as well as by the developer, but your validation process done by quality control team or by the tester, both are necessary here. And our validation process also cost as well as time tracking, not is effective. We can see cost tracking and time tracking process, which will be validation. That means the cost estimation we provide to our user. In that cost, your product will be developed or not. That quality track cost tracking, as well as in given time, our project will be completed or not. That time tracking also happening in the validation process. Then the activities involved are inspection, reviews, all of the activities involved in the validation process. That means you can inspect the project. All functionalities are inspections of functionality here. Then what are the reviews about the project, about the functionalities, about the some modules, all other things based in this validation process. I hope you understood verification as well as validation. And then the last question of today's video, which is explain SDLC. You have to explain SDLC. We already see the first question based on SDLC, then related questions about the SDLC. But now we have to explain what is SDLC. What is SDLC? So what is the full form of SDLC? First of all, SDLC stands for Software Development Life Cycle. And it is the most important concept in your manual testing or automation testing. Any testing, you have to explain the SDLC. So SDLC stands for your software development life cycle, which refers to all the activities that are performed during software development. All activities which are performed during software development, including requirement analysis, designing, implementation, testing, deployment, as well as maintenance phase, all are the things based in the SDLC. So SDLC basically from top to bottom about your software development. That means whenever your software development process start, what are the activities involved? All are the activities in SDLC, software development life cycle. In that life cycle, first of all, we have to include the first activity, or we done the first activity, which will be the requirement analysis. What are the requirement of our client? We have to analyze that. After analyzing all the requirement about the software, then we can design that particular module model about that software. And once we are designing of the model of software completed, then we can implement. Actual coding will be started of as per that design. In the designing phase, you can complete multiple diagrams and all other things, multiple models, and based on that model, actual implementation will be start in the third phase. And in that implementation phase, you can code your software. You can do the coding about your software. After that, the next phase will be testing. And once your coding will be completed, then the next phase will be testing. You have to test your project. What are you develop? That product will be fulfill your client's requirement or not? You have to verify that in that testing phase. Then what is deployment? The next phase will be deployment. So what is deployment? Deployment means once your testing will be successfully completed, your project satisfy all the requirement of your client, then you can deploy the system to your client, your client's machine. So all of the things in the deployment as well as maintenance phase also present here. Once you deploy the software, then you have to maintain that software is necessary. So all of the things based in the SDLC. I hope you understood. And if you that's it for today's video. And if you want to watch the next video also in on that topic of interview manual testing interview questions and answer, please let me know in the comment section, as well as validation, verification and QAQC detail information. If you want it, please let me know in the comment section. And please tell me, is this video is little bit helpful for you or not? Any requirement from your side, you have contact with me by using comment section or by using my mail. So I hope you understood today's video and it will be little bit helpful for you. So stay tuned for the next video, and we can meet in the next year. So happy new year in the advance, and for watching this video. Thank you so much, friends.